Always in the center ring, the President of the United States commands attention over all other performers on the political stage. With the advent of war, the other rings empty. The audience silences, and the spotlight intensifies as the Commander-in-Chief rhetorically focuses the attention of the nation on the coming battle. In ancient times, rulers frequently led their troops into battle, and their oratory was reserved for their combatants. Still, the tradition of Henry V inciting his troops once more and to the breach endures, but with a different audience. Understanding that in a democracy, words matter, a modern president's clarion to battle must convince his populace of voters that this great killer of youth is necessary. As St. Thomas Aquinas once reasoned, for leaders to go into battle, they require public authority, just cause, and right motive. The difficulty of leading their countrymen on this journey from peace to war depends on circumstances. In any case, it demands a specialized oratory. A president's rhetorical journey from peace to war generally proceeds in four steps. Presidents invariably describe the provoking evil deeds of their enemy. They justify our entry into war. Although they lament the nature of war, they conclude by inspiring their listeners that they will, nonetheless, prevail. Thus, the four steps are 1, provocation; 2, justification; 3, lamentation; and 4, inspiration.